We're gonna take another instrument, which is very common in all sorts of music, not only Oriental, but Western too, but it's a very specific type of how it's played in Oriental songs. And we're gonna work with violin. Right away, we're gonna work with a very famous song, Yearning. And pay attention, it's still, it's also uplifted. So we are switching from uplifted, so from grounded ballad, uplifted ney, grounded saidi, now back to uplifted. But it's not gonna also, it will call you not only to engage your upper body, but a lot of arms, a lot of flowy things. So pay attention to song, it's also a very dramatic song. You can take it on traveling whenever you feel, or keep it on one spot if you have limited space to practice. But again, pay attention to violin and how your body wants to react to it. Again, you can close eyes if you want. This is not a performance. This is marking practice. So take it easy and pay attention to music, first of all. Thank you. Very nice, very dramatic mood. Now, where we actually apply all this knowledge? Accordion, more grounded, Nain violin, more uplifted, Mizmar, Saidi cue, etc. Not only for the separate songs itself, because typically you will not have a song with only one leading instrument. It can be, you heard examples, but typically it's not the case. But for instance, for your measure says, you may have a song where all these instruments appear, and also kanun, oud, all other ones. And if you dance in the same, if you dance in the same style or mood to, let's say, accordion, the same way you dance to violin, you're not only not reflecting different musical texture of instruments, but you're also reaping your dance of richness, because this is the cues for you to different movement vocabulary. So within one measure, say, you switch to from grounded hips whenever you hear accordion, if it's present, to suddenly uplifted violin showing arms, then suddenly to Saidi section, and for instance, we didn't talk about this in this drill, but kanun reflecting shimi and mood too. And all this together creates a very rich, varied, engaging choreography or improvisation on stage. So I hope you enjoyed this drill. You're welcome to repeat it again, maybe several times, or go to a playlist indicated in this drill and find this or similar songs and practice improvisation on your own. Thank you for watching this short tip from the Iana Dance Club. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you want to continue studying with me and dive more into full classes, full choreographies, full workouts, don't forget to check my online teaching platform. You can find more information about Iana Dance Club in this video. And if you want to continue browsing different tips that I shared on YouTube, you can check this link here. And finally, if you enjoyed this tip, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel so I post more information and more dance-related tips in the future.